Now let's consider the theory of optimal tariffs. What we'll see here is that sometimes a tariff can help an individual nation, but without helping the world as a whole. I'll show this with a simple example, but the key assumption is going to be that the tariff-imposing nation is economically large, in the sense that it can, to some extent, alter world prices. So examples of economically large nations would be, for instance, China, or also the United States. In this example, let's consider the United States, which is buying oil from Saudi Arabia. To make this as simple as possible, let's use some assumptions. For instance, we'll assume that the Saudis have market power over oil, that they are selling only to the United States, and also let's assume that the Saudis are producing oil at a marginal cost of zero. The point here is not that these are realistic, but that they will help us focus in on the one key mechanism behind optimal tariff theory, and I'll again stress the key assumption is that the United States is an economically large country in the sense that its buying decisions, its taxes, its policies can affect global prices as a whole. So here we can see the demand curve for Saudi oil, first in the absence of a tax, and to maximize profits with zero marginal cost, the Saudis will choose this point on the demand curve, and we will get this market quantity in equilibrium and this here market price. And profit for the Saudis will be given by the size of this rectangular box here. And now let's assume that the United States is imposing an import tax, and the value of that import tax will be at, by assumption, 50%. In essence, we are now seeing that one half of this profits box is going to the United States in the form of revenue from the import tax rather than going to the Saudis. The price paid by U.S. buyers won't change, but the price received by the Saudi suppliers, well, that will be half of the old price. But you'll see in this setting the quantity of oil sold will not change. Without the tax, the Saudis were basically maximizing P times Q to get their profit, and now in essence they're maximizing one half of P times Q, and the way to maximize one half of P times Q is still to maximize P times Q, and that will mean the same quantity of oil supplied to the market, but at better terms for the Americans. Just to recap that all in written form, after the import tax, U.S. buyers are paying the same price for oil, the quantity of oil sold is the same as before the tax, and some of the proceeds go to the U.S. Treasury rather than to the Saudis. That is indeed a better outcome for the United States, but note carefully, it's not a better outcome for the world as a whole. In more complicated examples, we may find that the Saudis shift some of their sales to other markets, perhaps with lower taxes. It may be the case that the price to U.S. buyers will indeed go up, and there also may be some output cost in the sense of the Saudis end up selling less oil to the United States. Still, if the United States can use the tariff to get a terms of trade effect, it's still the case that they will be able to redistribute income away from the Saudis and toward the United States. In general, the optimal tariff for the importing country is higher when supply, in this case supply of the oil, is inelastic, because then you can impose the tariff and there are fewer other places the oil might go. We can think of this import tax as replicating a form of buyer collusion. If all of the U.S. buyers of Saudi oil could get together in a room and collude and agree not to buy the oil unless the Saudis lower their price, well, that would redistribute income away from the Saudis and toward the United States. The import tax, in essence, is replicating a form of that collusion. By imposing the tax, the U.S. government is getting U.S. buyers to be less willing to buy Saudi oil, and the only way the Saudis can counteract that is indeed to lower the price of their oil. Note also in international trade theory, anytime you have an argument about imports, you can actually flip it into an argument about exports, because indeed in this case we have a two-country model, and the trade which is going on is actually a form of barter. So you also can think of this tax on oil imports as being like a tax on U.S. exports to the Saudis. In essence, that tax is cartelizing the U.S. exporters and getting them a higher price, noting that the revenue from that higher price may be flowing to the U.S. Treasury rather than to the U.S. exporters themselves. And that's simply the flip of the argument about the import tax. So just to state the key result again, a tariff can help a large country by shifting the terms of trade in its favor. But of course, in the real world, this is actually not so simple, and one problem is quite simply the other country, the Saudis in this example, they may retaliate. But in general, this is not the end of the story. So imagine that the Saudis, or maybe a bunch of other countries acting together in concert, they impose a tariff on U.S. exports. Well, in that case then, these terms of trade gains may go away. We'd end up with a situation where consumers in both countries or all the countries would face higher prices, but again, there's not necessarily a terms of trade shift in the favor of the United States. One rationale for free trade agreements and free trade zones may simply be that they help us to avoid these mutually destructive outcomes, whereby a bunch of individual countries try to shift the terms of trade in their favor, they all do this, and no one ends up better off. To pursue this topic further, well, one thing you can do is simply Google optimal tariff theory, or put that in scholar.google.com. There's the Feenstra and Taylor book, International Trade. Thomas Humphrey has a good article on the intellectual roots of optimum tariff theory. See also our videos on John Stuart Mill and Torrens on this. And also there's a very interesting piece, Optimal Tariffs and Market Power, The Evidence, and that looks at the question of whether optimal tariff theory actually predicts to some extent where and when countries actually levy tariffs.